began where it began in 1971 in a graduate program, rendering living rooms from Sears and Roebuck catalogs and wondering, wouldn't it be smarter, wouldn't it be more interesting to knock on the door across the street from where I was living and see if I could take a photograph of the room instead of rendering it by hand. A lot of people in my generation wanted to make work that was more social, more political, more connected with the so-called real world than those of us who were previously isolated in our studios, and we decided to go into the world. And I decided that I really wanted to make work about the world, but as much about the world as it was about art. I should just say from the very first pictures, and the pictures you'll see in this show, the world looked to me like a ready-made installation piece of art that one could find in a contemporary art museum. All you had to do is put a rope in front of it, and there it was, a finished piece of work. The work started with that in mind, again, wanting to be social, political, but also wanting to be funny. How can the world be so hilarious? I mean, sometimes people saw my work as cold, and I said to them, why don't you just put on a coat and have another look? Maybe this whole project is based on sort of art bravura, that how little it takes for you to think you're underwater, for example, or how little it takes to make you feel that you're in the clouds, in Magritte's clouds. I came to this kind of work at a certain point in my life when I had an idea that I'm a sense of what I wanted to do, and I've just been going after that from the beginning. I don't feel that this is history. I mean, maybe I should. I don't know.